Good morning, kids. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing great at your home. I'm Khushbu Patel from Saraswati Group of Education, and today I'm conducting this session for your computer subject. I hope you have done well in your exam. Now, we know that in chapter number 2, before your exam, we have completed hard words. So now, for this session, I'm going to start with the explanation of this chapter. What is our chapter's title, which is Useful Features in Word 2016? That means when we talk about a computer, there are so many software and updated version is coming every time. So Word, we all are aware with this. Word means what? Here we are talking about MS Word, that is Microsoft Word. It has so many versions like MS Word 2007, because it was launched in 2007, then 2010, then we have 2016, and then we have 2019, right? This one is the latest one. But from all this, we have to study about the features which was there in Word 2016. And so only here it is written features in Word 2016. Now, Word is what? It is considered as word processing software. That means it allows us to type in a text and we can do formatting of that text, like changing of color, setting up of margin, and many more things. So from all that features, we are going to learn few features in this chapter. But as it is a practical based lecture, we cannot do it orally. So today we will see this lecture in a different way. So are you all ready? Let's start.
Okay kids, so as now we are moving towards to the practical portion of a computer subject. Right, today I will show you practical program. Now, we have started with lesson number 2, that is useful features in Word 2016, that is 2016. Now, I told you that Word is a, yes, word processing software in which you can write in a text form. Now, first, here you can see this is my screen, which is considered as a desktop. Kids, first, I'm telling you the basic part of the computer. We all know that monitor, mouse, keyboard are considered as the basic part. But when you switch on the computer, the first screen which you see, that is known as what? It is known as desktop. Here, this is my desktop. On the first screen, you can see that there are small pictures, right, with having its name. Suppose right now my cursor is on our bin, that is recycle bin. Now if I am taking my cursor towards some other folder, right, it is getting into a box. That means a pictorial representation is given, the name of a software as well as its picture. So what is considered it? It is considered as the GUI, that is graphical user interface. Now the bottom line which you see here, right now my cursor is moving over there, so that bottom line is considered as what? It is considered as a taskbar, right? Now when I will switch on a one menu, that means when I will click on one menu, that is the start menu, you will see that it will open and it will show something like this. Here you can see many programs are written in a word formation with its picture. Here also you can see that there are certain graphic given, that means small pictures are given. So what is that? It is a graphical user interface where the people can identify the program from its picture. Now as I have told you that Word is word processing software, what do you mean by it? Now here I have made a one document which is in the Word only. See, it will take time to open. Here I have made it in Word 2010. It is a short story of a snake charmer. So you can see that here I have written everything into a Word. So when a program is providing you the interface to write any type of a text, that program or that interface is known as CUI, that is Character User Interface. I am entering the character inside and it is showing me the result based on my text instruction. So that command is known as a text command, and that interface is known as what? It is known as Character User Interface, right? So this was about the basic thing. Now I will close this file, as we have to understand Word 2016. So before I start that, take your textbook and open page number 14. So kids, now as you have opened your textbook, now see on page number 14, what is the topic, right? Let me write over here. We are going to study about spelling and grammar feature, right? We have studied these. What is the meaning of a spelling and what is the meaning of a grammar? That we have studied. But here we have to understand this in terms of a computer language. That means there is no other language for writing spelling and grammar in a word. But yes, sometimes it happens that when you write it, you misspell certain words. Your grammatical mistakes are there. So how can you identify that you have made a mistake? For that, we need to understand certain features in a word. MS Word or Microsoft Word is providing us that type of a feature, inbuilt feature. That means if we are making a mistake, it will highlight that word with a different color. Which type of a color? See, if I say that you have written certain wrong spelling, so red underline will be seen. That is for what? Wrong spelling, right? Then sometimes it is also showing green line. Green line means what? Green line means space, right? What is the meaning of a green line? Yes, green line is for space as well as it is also for grammar, right? Here you can see that I have written a grammar spelling wrong, but this is not MS Word, so it will not show any kind of a red line. So I have to check it by writing it, right? Okay, so these features we have to study. Now see in your textbook, it says page number 14, I'm talking about right now, we might make spelling and grammatical mistakes while typing text, right? We can make a mistake the way I have made a mistake in writing the spelling of a grammar. Yes, it happens. Sometimes when you write in your classwork without seeing from your textbook, or you can say when your teacher is dictating answer and you are writing, sometimes you can make a mistake. Yes, and you are making mistake, right? So when the book is being taken for a checking, at that time your teacher is doing the underline or maybe circle on that mistake with a red pen. Same way, when you are making a mistake of a grammar or a spelling in a Word program, they give us a one feature to check and to correct. See in your textbook, Word help us identifying this mistakes in the document, right? We can say that when we are writing certain spelling and certain sentences, it is highlighted with a different color underline. That means we have made a mistake. They are hinting us, that program is giving us hint that here we have made a mistake. See kids, first I am explaining you theoretically and then we will see it's practical, right? See in the textbook again, the spelling mistakes are underlined with a red wavy line while grammatical mistakes are underlined with a blue line. Now see, here I have written green line for a space and grammar. But in some new feature, or you can say in some new version of MS Word, blue line is highlighting the grammar mistake, right? So you will not remember the green line for grammar, instead you will remember the blue line for grammar. So these are the three lines which we can see in our Word document if we have made certain mistake. That means when you are typing and if you see this type of a line, you have to understand on your own that you have made a mistake, right? Please underline in your textbook also that a red line is for a wrong spelling and a blue line for grammatical mistake. Then next one, see on the next page, Word also puts red wavy underline under the words that are not available in its built-in dictionary. Now kids, we are typing certain messages in mobile, right? So sometimes it happens that when we type in a certain language, that means we are writing in Gujarati language, but that Gujarati language we are writing in a spelling form, right? So it is not available in the dictionary of a mobile, right? Many of the devices, or you can say all the devices, are having built-in dictionary, right? So some of the words which we are writing, and if in that built-in dictionary is not available, then also you can have the red wavy line, right? Or here I can write for certain new words which is not available in the dictionary, right? That time also you can see the red line under that particular word, right? Now see, this may include the names of people, local places, cuisines, etc. That means you are typing in a word and then you are writing your name. Your name does not have any meaning in an English dictionary. So when you are writing your name, at that time it happens that under that word, that means under the name of yourself, you can see the red line. Why? Because that word is not there in the dictionary. Sometimes you are also writing your address, right? So local places you will write, that means the landmark near your house you will write. So if that spelling is not available in the dictionary of the computer, it will show a red color line, right? Okay, cuisine. Cuisine means, yes, cuisine means khane peene ki cheese. So even if you are writing the name of special items, special dishes, yeah, special cuisine, so that time also you can see a red line, right? So you just have to understand that line means mistake. Different color line is showing the different mistake. And what is the color and what is the mistake? Here I have highlighted. Clear? Now we are moving to the next thing. That is the first feature of this chapter. What is that first feature? I told you prior only that it is a spelling and grammar feature, right? So see in your textbook, we can check for spelling and grammar mistakes in the entire document by using the spelling and grammar feature, right? Now I'm closing this file, right? As we don't need to save, so I will give don't save option, so my file will be, yes, won't be saved. Now how to start MS Word, right? Microsoft Word I want to start. So in here taskbar, I will directly write the name of my program. So here you can see that similar words jahan se shuru hote hain wo sare programs ki list aa jayegi. From that you have to select the program which you want to open. Here we are going to open Word, but which version? I have two Word. Here you can see that I have Microsoft Word 2010 and here I have 2016. So as per your chapter, we have to start with Word 2016. So let me open it. As in when you will click it on, you will see a one home page, or you can say the main screen will be seen of that program. There are so many different type of letter formats are given. From that we have to choose the blank document, right? So this is the screen of a MS Word. This is the first screen. Here you can say that this is what, this is the menu bar, and these all are the contents which we can use for a different thing, right? Now let me write something, but before that I will change the font, and of course I will also change the size so that you can easily see it, right? Let me change it again. I am writing this, right? You will see that immediately when I am giving a space, immediately with that word a red wavy underline is there. Why? Because this is what? This is the name of a person, right? So name of the person won't be available in the built-in dictionary, so it will be highlighted with the red color line, right? Now let me erase it. Now I will write this. Rajkot is there in the dictionary, but if I'm writing, so you will see that here Bhakti Nagar, right, where I have written, there is a line. Why? Because this is the name of the place which is not there in the dictionary of the computer, right? So this is what, this is a mistake. That means this program is hinting us that this is a mistake, and because it is highlighted with the red color, we need to understand that maybe a spelling mistake, or maybe it is a name of a place, of a person, or of something else, right? Okay, now let me erase it. Okay, here in the file, as we have to understand the spelling and grammar feature, how will we understand? Before you start writing your document, just go to the file menu. The last one, options, are written. Just click on it. A one window panel will open. In the left hand side, you have to select proofing. What is the meaning of proofing? Proofing means my document is getting ready. So if there is any mistake, I want to see it, whether it is a grammar, whether it is a spelling, right? So here it is a tick mark. तो अगर मैं वो निकाल दूंगी तो मेरी स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक मुझे नहीं दिखाई देगी. सो आपको ऐसे ही रखना है टिक करके, राइट? देन यू जस्ट हैव टू क्लिक ऑन ओके, राइट? नाउ अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू चेंज द फॉन्ट साइज एंड आई विल राइट समथिंग. दिस इज द स्पेलिंग ऑफ अ स्नेक, राइट? Here you can see that I have written all the letters in a block and I have highlighted it with a bold mark. Fine. Now this is the correct spelling or a wrong spelling? Yes, it is a correct spelling. So when I'm pressing a space, it will not give any type of underline. But let me do one thing. I have removed it, right? So what will I do? Is there any mistake? Yes. So I will go on the review tab, right? As in when you will click on the review tab, you will see that there are so many options will be seen. From that, I want to check spelling and grammar, right? Spelling and grammar check is complete. Aisa likha hai. But we know that it is a mistake. So what we will do again? We will select it. Again, we will go to the file menu, then option, right? And then again proofing, and then we'll go to okay, right? Then press. Now kids, as you can understand that here I have written a wrong spelling of a snake, but still there is no underline, right? So what will I do? There is a one mistake, we know. But let me tell you kids that when you are typing in a word, only first letter should be capital, other should be written in a small cases. So that was a mistake. Just to make you understand that in a Word document, you have to write in a sentence form. That means only first letter capital, other should be in a small letter. Right? So this one, again I have written snake and then I am removing it. That means I am removing one letter. And then if I will press a space bar, you will see it will highlight it with the red color. That means there is a spelling mistake. So the way I told you that again you have to go in the file and option menu, proofing, and again you just have to check ki yahan pe submit tick mark hai ya nahi, last mein nahi hona chahiye, then press OK. Then go to review tab, click on it and see spelling and grammar. Right, when I'm taking my cursor on this, you will see ki ek floating dialog box ye wala khul jata hai, which is also showing me the shortcut key. If you will see in the bracket, it is written F7. So either you press F7 from your keyboard or you press spelling and grammar tab with the help of a mouse. So as and when you will click on it, jo bhi aapki spelling mein galtiyan hain वो आपको दिखाई देगी और उसके रिलेटेड जो भी स्पेलिंग्स है वो आपको दिखाई देंगे कि आपको स्नेक का स्पेलिंग बनाना है, स्नैक का स्पेलिंग बनाना है, राइट, व्हाट यू वांट टू राइट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ विंडो पैनल, राइट, फ्रॉम विच व्हाट एवर द स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक्स आर देयर इट विल बी शोन, राइट, दैट विच स्पेलिंग. सो अगेन इफ आई विल क्लिक हियर दैट आई वॉन्ट टू चेंज दिस स्पेलिंग from S-N-A-K to S-N-A-K-E. So I will click here, then I will press on the change button, right? So you will see that the spelling is automatically changed and you will get a message that spelling and grammar check is complete. You just have to press OK, right? That way you can check any type of a spelling mistake and a grammar mistake. Now see in your textbook, we are just reading the steps how to check it. As we have completed watching the practical, now we will see it theoretical. So see in your textbook, the first step, click on the spelling and grammar option in a proofing group on the review tab, right? See, this is the review tab. This group is known as a proofing. This group is known as a language. This group is known as a comments, right, and many more. We have to go in which group? Proofing. And in that proofing also we have to click on what? Spelling and grammar. As in when you click on it, a one pane will open. Here we have done it already, so it will say that spelling and grammar check is complete. So see in your textbook, the spelling or grammar pane appears on the right side of the document window, right? For each error in the document, Word offers one or more suggestion, right? Jaise humne dekha tha that if I am removing E and if I will go on spelling and grammar, you will see that I can see many options, right? From that option which I want to choose, I will click on it. Suppose I want to make it as a snack, you can see snake will get convert to snack, but we have to click on change again. So the spelling will be there, right? Now see, there is a blue line. Blue line means grammatical mistake. What is the grammatical mistake? That first letter is what? It is a small, but it should be capital. See here, you can see capitalize the first word of a sentence. So that is our mistake. So I will do again a change and my mistake is overcome. It is totally removed or it is corrected automatically, right? See, for each error in the document, Word offers one or more suggestions. Click on the change button to replace the current misspelled word with the chosen word in the suggested list, right? The way it was suggested. Again, I'm opening, you can see there are so many suggestions, right? So from that suggested list, whatever the word you want to choose, you can choose and immediately click on change, right? See, Click on the change button to replace the current misspelled word with the chosen word in the suggested list. Click on the change all button to replace all the occurrences of the misspelled word with the chosen word in the suggested list. Sometimes it happens that you write many of the spelling, right? And all the spelling are having certain mistake, right? So what will you do? You will choose one. And that spelling you want to choose as a scan and change all, right? So jahan jahan pe same mistake hogi, that will get converted to what? New spelling, right? Okay, so whatever the spelling you want to change, you can do. And still, say for example, aapne kisi ka naam likha hai, kisi place ka naam likha hai, ya kisi khane ka naam likha hai, you don't want to change that name. So you just have to click on what? You have to click on ignore, right? Dekhiye. I know that this is the mistake, but I will put a click on ignore. Matlab, that line will be removed. You can see that there is a spelling mistake, but I said to ignore, so it will be removed, right? Okay. Click on the add button to add the word to the dictionary. When a word is added to the dictionary, word no longer is highlighted it as a misspelled word. Say for example, here I just want to write this. Okay. Done? Okay. There is no word like this, RRR, but I want to add it. So it will be added to the dictionary and it won't be highlighted again. Right? Clear? Okay. Now see the third step. When the word is through with the spelling and grammar check, it is displaying a message box. Right? Again, there's no one. So again, I will go to this and add. Okay, see, this one is the message box. Click on the OK button to complete the process. We just have to click on OK button. That means in the entire document, the spelling and grammar mistake is checked and corrected. Again, kids, I'm repeating, you can do it with the help of a mouse, as well as you can also do it with the help of a shortcut keys. Right, in your textbook, if you will see on page number 15, there is a shortcut key for checking the spelling and grammar error, that is F7. Clear? So this was the first feature in the Word document. Next time we are going to see the new feature. Okay, kids?
So kids, as you have seen this, now I hope you have understood. So if you have a computer at your home, try to do these things which I have taught you today. So after this, I am ending my session over here. Right? And for any query, you will go through this video again. We will meet next time. Till that time, I am taking your leave. Bye bye.